ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಬಿಬಿಎಂಪಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಮಹಾನಗರ ಪಾಲಿಕೆ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಐತಿಹಾಸಿಕವಾದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಹಮ್ಮಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪನಿಯಿಂದ ಅವರ ಸಹಯೋಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅಂದರೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಮಹಾನಗರ ಪಾಲಿಕೆಯ ಚೌಕಟ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸುಮಾರು 150 ಶಾಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಆಧುನೀಕರಣಗೊಳಿಸಿ ಅವುಗಳನ್ನು ಏನು ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೊಸ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಇಡೀ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅನುಗುಣವಾಗಿ ಆ ಶಾಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಮೇಲೆ ತರಬೇಕು ಹಾಗೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಅವರ ಜೊತೆ ಒಪ್ಪಂದವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ತಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಷನ್ ಶಾಲೆಗಳು ಅಂತೇಳಿದರೆ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಆ ಶಾಲೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಕಳಿಸೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಿಂಜರಿಯುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸರಿಯಾದ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಷನ್ ಶಾಲೆಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಅವರ ಗುಣಮಟ್ಟ ಖಾಸಗಿ ಶಾಲೆಗಳ ಹಂತಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲದೇ ಇರೋದು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಕಾರಣ. ಹತ್ತಾರು ವರ್ಷದ ಹಿಂದೆ ಅನೇಕ ಶಾಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಆದರೆ ಅವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಕಟ್ಟಡ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅವುಗಳ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣದ ಪದ್ಧತಿ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅವುಗಳಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಉಪಾಧ್ಯಾಯರ ಗುಣಮಟ್ಟ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಇದೆಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಳತೆಗೋಲು ಮಾಡಿ ನೋಡಿದರೆ ಬಹುಶಃ ಖಾಸಗಿ ಶಾಲೆಗಳ ಮಟ್ಟಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕೆಳಮಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಾವೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಮಗೆ ಕಂಡುಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಆ ಶಾಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಗುಣಮಟ್ಟದ ಶಾಲೆಗಳನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಮತ್ತು ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಷನ್ ಶಾಲೆಗಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಬಹಳ ಒಂದು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಸಡ್ಡೆಯಿಂದ ಜನ ಏನು ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಬಡ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಎನ್ನುವಂಥ ಕಲ್ಪನೆ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಬದಲಾಯಿಸಬೇಕು ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪನಿಯ ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಪ್ರಥಮವಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಅಭಿನಂದನೆಯನ್ನು ಸಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಕಂಗ್ರ್ಯಾಚುಲೇಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ದೆಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಟಿವ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬಬ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ that an initiative of this nature has been taken up by the Microsoft. Idralli new would you like to explain to them later or you want me to do that?
If you can explain
again. No, I just use my preamble and afterwards you can continue that. Yeah, then it is wonderful. ಸೊ ನಾನು ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಹೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ, ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಪವರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಳ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ಒಟ್ಟಾರೆ ಪರಿಸರವನ್ನು ಮೊದಲನೇದಾಗಿ ಆ ಪರಿಸರವನ್ನು ಬದಲು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಶಾಲೆ ಕಟ್ಟಡದಿಂದ ಹಿಡಿದು ಅಲ್ಲಿಯ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ಗಳಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅದಾದ ಮೇಲೆ ಉಪಾಧ್ಯಾಯರಿಗೆ ತರಬೇತಿಯನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಇರ್ಬೋದು. ಪ್ರಥಮವಾಗಿ ಮೇಸ್ಟ್ರುಗಳನ್ನು ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಗುಣಮಟ್ಟದ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅವರು ಹಾಗೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಫಸ್ಟು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು. ಅದಾದ ಮೇಲೆ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಮೆಥಡಾಲಜೀಸ್, ಆಧುನಿಕವಾಗಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಪಾಠ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದನ್ನ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದನ್ನ ಮತ್ತು ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ವೈಜ್ಞಾನಿಕವಾಗಿ ತಾಂತ್ರಿಕತೆಯನ್ನು ಉಪಯೋಗ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣವನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದನ್ನು ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅವರು ಈ ಯೋಜನೆಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ರೋಶ್ನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಸರನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಆ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸನ್ನು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ತಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಆಗಲೇ. ಅದರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅವರು ಪವರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣವಾಗಿ ಈ ಶಾಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಬದಲಾಯಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಇನ್ನು ಕೆಲವೇ ವರ್ಷಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಖಾಸಗಿಯವರ ಜೊತೆ ಒಂದು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಮಟ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಆ ಶಾಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ತರಬೇಕು ಹಾಗೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಅವರು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದರಿಂದ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಬಾರಿಗೆ ಇಡೀ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಷನ್ ಶಾಲೆಗಳು ಖಾಸಗಿ ಶಾಲೆಗಳಾಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಗುಣಮಟ್ಟದ ಶಾಲೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅವುಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಬೆಳೆಯುತ್ತವೆ. ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಆ ಬಡ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಅಂತಹ ಅವಕಾಶಗಳನ್ನು ಕಲ್ಪಿಸೋದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹಾಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಅಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಅವರನ್ನು ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಟು ನೋ ಗೋ ಅಹೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಬೆಟರ್ ವೇ.
That means in the first genre of learning we used to have the Gurukul system, then we have the four walls of the classroom, and today it's a connected learning community. And today all the BBMP schools, all the BBMP schools are going to be called a connected learning community. I'll take you through this presentation. See, first of all, we have to implement a state-of-art technology in the institutions for institutions to grow. Second is, improve the infrastructure to meet the highest level. That means we are not taking any money from the government schools. We are trying to improve it on a CSR basis. The other thing is training the teachers on the 21st century learning. You'll be happy to know that three of the BBMP teachers have got MIS certificates, that is Microsoft Innovative Educator Certificate, just named for yesterday, and we are trying to convert many more teachers on the education of the 21st century. Then embrace the communities to involve in the carrying out the experiential learning. Now there is no such thing as textbook learning anymore. What we should do is we must have all in the learning through experts and experiential learning. That's what we are trying to bring in. Then the school should be coached to be future ready. Now every single school is going to be future ready. When I say future ready, I say that it's an international standard, not the current what you see in the private schools in India. Then the other very important part is when the leadership of Karnataka, they said that no child should be left behind. These schools are not only for underprivileged children. Tomorrow schools, children can come and study from private schools into these schools. So we are following something called a No Child Left Behind policy here, and impart education based on syllabus as well as a curriculum which will be inclusive curriculum. Okay, now for the inclusive curriculum, what we have done is we have formed about 15 different advisory committees, like your sports, games, arts, music, health, technology, education, social forestry. All this thing, what will happen is the experts will come and train the students how to do all these things. Apart from classroom learning, they'll be learning from outside the classroom through the community also. Then the new format of learning today in the world is not 3 R's, it's gone to 5 C's. What are the 5 C's? creativity, communication, collaboration, critical thinking, and computational thinking. Now, what happens is our children are very good in creativity and critical thinking. The other things we need to build, especially the computational thinking. That's what we're trying to implement in the schools. We are trying to bring in the world's best technology into the classroom. Here, what happens is, we have got two companies, that's Microsoft and Tech Avantgarde, who's come together to put this entire program into the schools. So Microsoft has got a program called MASP Pro, which is a Microsoft Schools Aspiring Program. The entire information is given to y'all. The other thing is Roshni Social Schooling. Now, this is the latest concept in schooling. That is, not only the child is getting schooled inside the school, but by the community also. This is what is experiential learning all about, and we are going to implement this. Once this happens, the schools will turn into a connected learning community. It's a 2020 vision of UNESCO. That means Karnataka will have a connected learning community 2 years ahead of the world. So this vision of UNESCO was formed 18 years back, and Karnataka has adopted it, and this will be the lighthouse schools lab. I'll just explain what is this connected learning community is all about. That is, students, educators, and parents has anytime, any place access to learning. That means they can learn on any device from any place. The second is, learning is relevant, individualized, and personalized. Now, suppose you see a child, they always cannot learn, read and learn, or see and learn, or things like that. Their teaching should be personalized. So therefore, we are going to bring it into the schools. Then schools have information system that supports accountability. Now what will happen is, we've already put in the system in place that the minister will be able to see wherever he is, the attendance of children, what they are studying, how many teachers are there in the classroom, what syllabus has been done, what is the different results of each of these children. Everything will come to know about on a e-governance kind of a system here. Then we have got school campuses, homes, libraries, businesses, and global resources connected in a dynamic way. Now we are connecting this classroom on a Skype to the classrooms of the world. Now, once this program is over, we're going to start training the children in French from France. We will be training something about Antarctica from an explorer sitting in Antarctica. So this is going to be the order of the day in terms of the BBMP schools. The other thing is, once this happens, we have to change the entire culture of the society. Today our society has become quite rough. I'm not talking about the Bangalore society, I'm talking about the entire society of the world. So what's going to happen in this kind of a learning is, we'll have ecological sustainability and opposed to green exploitations. So suppose you see news every day, the rivers are getting flooded, the mountains are getting washed away, only because there's no sustainability. The other thing is, value-based principles as opposed to self-centric existence. So it will be like a give and take from everybody. Everybody will be starting to appreciate each other. Then spirituality and holistic living. Now, children will be taught how to be soft in schools. They will be taught spirituality and how they will interact with each other. Then social consciousness against exploitation. This is very important, social consciousness. Because these children come from very meager backgrounds, and we want them to hold their heads high and go into the world. That's what we're trying to put into this system. Then the thrust areas. What is going to be the thrust areas? Social justice and empowerment. Very important. I mean, I was hearing Minister a long time back when he came and spoke in Bishop Cotton School, and he spoke only about social justice and empowerment, which made a lot of sense. Then plurality, diversity and flexibility. We must give the flexibility of the students to learn whatever they want to learn. It shouldn't be only syllabus-based learning. Then technology, then relevance in technology, competencies and sustainability of environment. Now we're going to put social forestry into the schools. That is, we're going to bring in water harvesting. We have just started implementing solar energy in the schools. All these things are going to be very important. Then we have got a multiple intelligence platform and multiple assessment patterns. See, as I told you earlier, we are no more having the 3 R's. We have to go to 5 C's, and we have to implement the multiple intelligences platform. Apart from that, we're going to shift from acquisition of knowledge to knowledge management. Now, if you look at a child, they want to score 90-95%. Still, when they come out of the schools, they're not too good in their studies, or they cannot be too good in their workplaces. So we're going to use this knowledge management basically. Then consumerization to ecological sustainability. I keep on coming back to this ecological sustainability, because if we don't do that, we'll lose our world tomorrow, and our children will lose our world. So that's why the ecological sustainability is very important, and it's very important for the government schools to start. That's why I congratulate PDMP schools to start this. Then conventional to convergence of technology. Conventional technology you can have, but convergence of technology like your mobile phones, like your tablet, PCs, all those things are going to come into the schools. Then 3 R's, as I said, I told you, reading, writing, arithmetic, that's where we learn, that's how we learn. But now it's the 5 C's I explained to you as a multiple intelligences platform. Now, what is going to happen when this thing is implemented? What's going to be the outcomes of this project? Empowerment of less privileged by adopting community schools. Then, these schools will have the world-class infrastructure. That means we will build the infrastructure. We'll not be depending on anybody else to build it. We'll build it through our CSR funds. Then, we'll also implement technologies such as virtual reality, augmented reality, artificial intelligence, machine learning, STEM, STEAM, and cloud-based learning. Also, IoTs and bots. Now, bots are very important. Bots are kind of a software which can reply back to the human being. Now, let's say one of it is Alexa. When they ask them questions, Alexa replies back. Now, that we want to bring into the classroom. Suppose a student wants to ask something to the computer, or a parent wants to ask something to the computer, or to the device, and say, "How did my child do?" It should reply back and say, "How your child did." That's the most important part. Then teachers will be trained on 21st century learning, and we're going to put a classroom called Knowledge Lavineers. This is the latest thing which is happening in the world, wherein the classrooms are going to be transformed into the futuristic classrooms. Then the parents will be made aware of the changes. The important part is the parent, because parent has to be a part of the schooling system now. Otherwise, we cannot have that, because if the children go back home, they'll be again illiterate. We don't want that to happen. So then, the parents will also be involved in activities of the school. Then students will be made environmentally and culturally aware and socially adapt. Now, socially adaptation is very, very important, because children will be taught good habits in the school. Then students will be guided to choose hobbies and sports. Then experts for local community will start collaborating with the school, and these institutions will become lighthouse schools. Now, a lighthouse school is a very important part, because these are awards that the school gets. And I'm sure the BBMP school will get a lighthouse school award. It's a worldwide award.